Today I want to talk to you about shepherds, herding breeds. So in the shepherds there are so many herding breeds available. Today I will limit myself to those found in Germany. And then, for example, Rottweiler, I don't count as a shepherd or herding breed. Some say that even a Rottweiler can herd a cattle or something like that. So Germany, Belgium, the Netherlands, and perhaps I can also add some of France. So you got in France you got the Bucheron, which is a herding shepherd breed, closely resembling the Dobermann Pinscher, but with a little bit more strength. It also has a coat that is a little bit longer, and sometimes it's also offered as a Harlequin kind of dog, so with more Merle coloration. Lately, that leather coloration has taken a flight. Whereas in the past it was a mutation that one wouldn't want to have, because double girls or double harlequins are often a lot weaker and can get very serious deficits. The normal color of the Bucheron is black and tan, and it's I think still quite a natural, strong type of herding breed. That it's not that well known, and it's, if you look at the earlier pictures also of the Dobermann Pinscher, you see a close resemblance there. So just to take that into consideration, I think Bucheron can be used as a herding breed, but also quite capable as a protection breed. In both it won't excel as compared to the best breeds, but it's still a good all-rounder and something different. The Briard is also used as a herding breed, which can be used as both a protection dog and a herding dog, but in both it is not good. And if you want to know how a Briard looks like, it's a lot like an old English sheepdog, but then in without the white and black or white and grey colorations. It's more of a solid grey or solid blonde or solid blackish type of color. And a little bit bigger than French Briard, because the Briard is from French. There's also a dog that resembles it quite a bit, which is called the Bouvier des Flandres, which means the Flemish Bouvier. And Flemish region is a region in Belgium. It's also where my wife is from. And that dog is a lot taller, heavier than the Briard, and also has a more character to it. In the past, also in the Netherlands, they had a lot of these Bouvier des Flandres dogs, because they worked well, had a weather resistant coat, very well take care of the farm, protect the house, the family, the children, which makes it a very nice all-around farm dog. So also this dog is a good all-rounder. I would like to have a Bouvier if the coat would be a little bit less in length. I think sometimes too much length, especially the coat, will hinder more than that it brings you benefits. The benefit of a longer coat would be, for example, more warmth, more isolation, of course. But Bouvier des Flandres is a very nice, strong dog, and if you cut it down and you take away the hairs, you see a herding shepherd-like appearance underneath there. So if you take this route from Brie to Bouvier, then you could also go to Belgium, which they have four shepherd breeds, starting with the most rarest, which is Lakense Herder, or I don't know how the should be in English Lakenois. I don't know, but this is a breed which looks a little bit like a cross between the shepherd and on one side and on the other side, Bouvier type of dog, or it's a little bit curly, and is one of the less known Belgian breeds, and also I think most of that is due to its appearance doesn't look that nice. But this is the coat that, although it doesn't look that nice, could be very functional, not too long, not too short, protects against weather, protects against bruises from vegetation, and also even if you have some pests. But it could also mean that in when the weather is too hot, the coat will also have a small detrimental effect, but I think it will be limited. Then in Belgium you also have two long-haired breeds. One would be the Der Vurense Herder, which has a black mask and also black dots on his coat. Underneath it's more brownish-reddish, which makes it a little bit like a flame dog. If you would compare it to different Belgian breeds, then it looks a lot like the Malinois, so the Mechelse Herder, as they call it. The other one is known as the Vurense Herder, but then with a lot longer coat. And the coat length is comparable to that of the Groenendaler, which is also another breed in Belgium, which is all black. And I think the Groenendaler is a very nice dog. Hey. Goedemorgen! Dat is misschien wel groot, hè? Zo! Hé, hey, jongen! Of meisje is het, hè? Ja. Kom maar. Hoi, hoi! Zo, de... Dit was het, hè? American booty. So, just to get back to the topic. They're all dark Groenendaler. Groenendaalse herder. They also call it in the Netherlands or in the Flemish part of Belgium. It's a dog completely the same as the Vurense Herder, so only the color is a little bit different. And also the benefit is that an all black dog can be very good in the night because it's hard to see them. It's like a black wolf. The Vurense Herder, on the other side, also has a coat that doesn't reflect that much, so it shouldn't be brought to that high of a degree of purpose. And also, sometimes the Groenendaler was, although it's more of a show dog, like the Der Vurense Herder is as well, it was bred into the Flemish bred Malinois. So we called it the Mechelse Herder, or Mechelaar. And that gives you an insight why some of the Mechelaars are all black now. So the Mechelaar is the most performance bred of the four brothers or nephews, so you want to name them. And that's also a Belgian breed. That is the breed most used in dog sports and also by the police over the entire world. So once in a time, maybe the German Shepherd was the most used, but now the Malinois has surpassed it by a big degree. And why did it do it? Malinois is very driven. It's still developing as a performance breed. There's also a difference between the Malinois as a show breed and the Malinois as a performance breed, because the first has a dictated look and also a closed book. Which means that it's only one race that is adding to that gene pool. Whereas in the performance breed, Malinois, also known as Malinois X, or X stands for crosses, also other breeds are introduced. So, for example, the Groenendaler is introduced. In the past, the strength of the Belgian shepherds was that all the four varieties could be interbreed, interbred. Especially, for example, you could have a Tervuren with long hair, a short head would be a Malinois, a black one would be a Groenendaler, and the curly one, that's the one that's the most different compared to the other three. But that was also a strength. And now the Malinois X is crossed into different breeds. So, for example, still the Groenendaler is added sometimes, but most it are the Dutch shepherds that were added, and also sometimes German shepherd or pit bull blood or other bull blood, for example, bull terrier to strength. Oi oi! Some even told me that once in a while, when they were line breeding very heavily, they got so much inbreeding depression that some lines even introduced Great Dane. Can you imagine that? Okay, but the Malinois is my my choice if one would look for a performance bred dog. Only one that would best it would be the Dutch Shepherds. So that brings the Dutch Shepherds. The Dutch Shepherds is very closely related to the Belgian Shepherd. Also, they have three varieties. They only have one color, which is streams, or the, like brindle, as you call it. And those brindle colorations, you get as a short head one, which closely resembles the Malinois, or the Mechelseherde, the Mechelaar. That's the Dutch Shepherd that you see the most. And then there are two varieties that's also a lot also present, but you see them a lot less. And the one is the long-haired one, which has that brindle coat, but combined with longer hair compared to the Hurense herder, also often a black mask, or the Groenendaler in the Belgian sister breeds. And you get a rough coat of the Dutch Shepherd. And that's very much related in the feel and also in the looks to the Lakense herder of Belgium. And the thing is, also the Dutch Shepherds, you have the Dutch Shepherd as a show dog, so the show confirmation, also close book, and then you have the Dutch Shepherd that's also used in the performance breeding, and then you get the Dutch Shepherd X, the Dutchie X. And the X again stands for crosses. So Dutch Shepherds, and especially crosses with Dutch Shepherds and Malinois, are the main consistent of the performance bred shepherd of today. Also in the Dutch Shepherds, it's a little bit stronger type, a little bit lower on the legs. And they say it already has some more bull influences in it. So more of a bull herder. And especially those Dutch Shepherd crosses could have a high degree of bull in them, being a pit bull or a bull terrier, but sometimes also other breeds are used. And also the Dutch Shepherd X can be crossed, for example, with a performance German Shepherd. But performance German Shepherds are rare as hen's teeth, as I say. A nice grass. So those are not found that often. I would love to have once a black Malinois or a very dark Dutch Shepherd with a Shepherd coat. I really like the black dogs, as you can see here. This is my 11-month-old black Veld Terrier, smooth coated, also known as the Patterdale. This is also a working breed. So if you have like a dark dog with a smooth coat and a working stock, that are the things that I find very nice to have. So back to the Shepherds. We started in France, then to Belgium, and then to the Netherlands. And as I mentioned, there's also another Shepherd, which is a German Shepherd. And the German Shepherd is a dog that is once was the main dog used in the military or police purposes, but has left its post. It is now only rarely used. And one of the reasons for that is that the German Shepherd, also known as a German Shepherd dog, or GSD, or in America also known as Alsatian, because in World Wars they had a bad affiliation with everything that would be German. It's all the same type of dog. It was used as a show dog, and they made that triangular angle bigger and bigger with each breeding. And the result is that so the shoulders at the front would be high, and the back end, the butt, would be very low, give that sloping feel. And the drawback of that is that the hips were really messed up with the hips. Also the strength of the back legs, and a lot of each dog's strength is in the back legs. So if you look at this terrier I have here, you see the musculature on the back legs. That's where the thrust, the driving force is. Also when they wrestle with their prey, they get a lot of power out of those back legs, and those are just completely ruined. So even if some breeders wanted to revigorate that working breed, in a German Shepherd they had a very bad stock to begin with. And that's the sad story of the German Shepherd. If you really, really want to have a German Shepherd, there are also old German Shepherd lines which breed a German Shepherd with a long coat. In the past you could breed them with long and short coat, but now the German Shepherd is only accepted as show dog with a short coat. And therefore, if you have like the older lines, which weren't that much ruined for show purposes, would be the longer head ones, which also brings a bigger dog. And in the East Germany, they have some lines that work a little bit better. So if you want to go there, that would be an option. You have to take the longer coat if you want to use that dog, but still a good way to go. Other ways could be to go to other variants of the German Shepherd, for example the Canadian Shepherd. It's also known as the Swiss Shepherd in the past. Well, I don't know which one is now the current one, but it's a breed based on the German Shepherd. It has different coat lengths as well, and you still have hips that are looking a little bit better because they're less exaggerated. And that's also a dog that is all white, always all white. And so in temperament it's even easier than a German Shepherd is, so even less drive in most of them, so that could be a way to go. On the other way, I mentioned that I really liked Malinois and also the Dutchies, the Dutch Shepherds of performance lines. But remember this, if you're not going to use it as a performance dog, you need to give it another task to complete. If not, it could be a dog that becomes a nuisance of to you and to itself. So just my thoughts on the shepherd breeds. I hope you liked it. I like to discuss it with you. There are many more shepherd breeds to look into, but these were the ones most used and the counties that have contributed the most. If you look at pure shepherd breeds, I think England, for example, the Border Collie, or Australia with the Kelpie have provided the best examples. And I was talking about the shepherd breeds as an all-round farm dog that could also help in the protection and is used as such in protection sports. Have a nice day.